Welcome back, guys, to another episode of CoinSpice. On this episode, I wanted to report on how Coinbase is moving forward and how it's going to become even bigger as an exchange. Now, for those of you who don't know, Coinbase has been around since some of the early days in cryptocurrencies. It's one of the early crypto exchanges that is still around and that has really been a reliable source of buying and selling cryptocurrencies for a long period of time. Now, I am aware that the fees at Coinbase are pretty high. If we look at the Coinbase volume right now, then it's doing around 280 million. That was today. You can see that Binance is right now the largest exchanges. And if you go to CoinMarketCap, a lot of these exchanges that have the fake volume are listed on CoinMarketCap. And you may have noticed that instead of the number of exchanges growing logarithmically, the top exchanges have relatively stayed similar. And it seems these exchanges are starting to become specialized in certain areas. So you see Binance becoming quite specialized in IEOs and ICOs. Kraken seems to have specialized in Euro to Bitcoin and Euro to other crypto spot positions. And Coinbase, on the other hand, seems to be moving more towards an institutional business model. And that also resonates with the recent news that we've been getting out of Coinbase. Coinbase recently, very recently, acquired Xapo. And you might have heard of Xapo already. It's been one of the largest wallet and custody providers for quite a few years now. Xapo is becoming a relatively old business in cryptocurrencies, if there is such a thing. You may have also heard a lot of those ETFs that kept getting delayed with their decision. They were also relying on Xapo, or were proposing to rely on Xapo if they did get approved. So Xapo in the cryptocurrency industry has a very strong reputation. Xapo apparently stores all of the Bitcoins that it holds in custody in cold wallet storages that are based in Switzerland. And Coinbase recently acquired Xapo's institutional business for around $55 million. And Fidelity was also after this Xapo institutional business service. It seems to be a gold mine right now. And it seems like Coinbase is moving more towards an institutional custody service type of a business model. It's no longer only focusing on consumers. As we all know, it's quite easy to buy cryptocurrencies using Coinbase's app. And after this acquisition, a lot of the businesses that were holding Bitcoins under Xapo services are now shifting towards Coinbase. And the total number of Bitcoins, 860,000 Bitcoins, which is just under 5% of the total number of circulating Bitcoins right now, not including the Bitcoins that are lost forever. So as you can see, Coinbase is becoming very big, very fast. And one more tweet from the Coinbase CEO, something that I can't confirm. Coinbase says that they're getting $200 to $400 million in cryptocurrencies from institution deposits every week. If you remember all of that hype from 2017 that institutions are coming, futures are coming, and all ETFs are coming, and all of this stuff was coming, and it never happened. Well, it would seem that it's becoming a reality now, and that's what Brian Armstrong is saying. Possibly the recent crypto spike we're seeing right now today might have come from some FOMO resulting from this tweet, but it's possible that this is actually true. Now, on this topic, I also want to move on to Bakkt, because we've been hearing about Bakkt for quite a while now, and they've been talking about beta testing and it becoming a final platform sometime soon. I think it was first going to be quarter two of this year, but it never happened, and it seems finally they are becoming a reality now. So Bakkt has finally gotten the clearance that it seemed to have been seeking, and this comes from the New York's Department of Financial Services, the DFS. And as a result, the CEO of Bakkt announced today that finally Bakkt's Bitcoin futures and warehouse is going to debut in September. If you look at Bitcoin as a commodity for a future service where a delivery has to happen at certain dates for different institutional investors, then of course, Bakkt will have to be a custodian of that Bitcoin for some time until the delivery date comes of that Bitcoin. So this is the whole business model behind the warehouse that they've created, and it's also received a license now. So it would seem that the final date for launch is now the 23rd of September. And Bakkt had already received, like Kelly says, a green light from the CFTC. And of course, the New York Stock Exchange itself, the largest stock exchanges in the world, is also located in New York. It's also regulated by the same department. And clarity is always something that we always strive for in cryptocurrencies. It's something that we haven't had for a long time. We're always waiting for some news to come out, either waiting for an ETF to be launched or something else. And finally, to get some clear guidance from a regulatory body, in my personal opinion, is definitely a good thing. It's much better than having lack of clarity. So for the time being, it would seem that Bakkt is ready to become one of the largest institutional cryptocurrency service providers in the very near future. So sounds like it will be easier for institutional investors to now buy Bitcoin. And this is key because if a recession does come in the US or the rest of the world, possibly these pension funds and investment funds and trusts and hedge funds will be looking at diversifying their assets and going more towards more longer term stores of value, perhaps like gold and perhaps like Bitcoin now. Perhaps cryptocurrencies will now be a genuine thing that institutions look at for storing wealth during recessionary times. And finally, I want to say that GBTC, which a lot of people that have wanted to put their pension money into Bitcoin have relied on, has traded at a quite significant premium for a while now. And GBTC right now is at around a 30% premium, if this website is correct, I think it is. And 30% of a premium on top of the price of Bitcoin, in my opinion, is quite a lot. So in my opinion, with the release of Bakkt and with an alternative for people, for institutions now to buy Bitcoin for their pension money, for their 401k, it's possible that the premium may go down. So just be aware of that if you are long on GBTC or any of the other services that it provides. I hope you found this episode useful. Make sure you hit the like button and also come over to my channel to have a look. I'll see you later.